Simple Cafe E, illustrated tutorials for your electronics. Hey, let's pick up 3 tips for working with your speaker wires. These will definitely help you if you're new to these cables, and even if you already have a lot of experience, you may still pick up at least one more tip. And watch out for the third one, everyone. It's a spicy one. Okay, number one, newbie or not, this here has happened to all of us, right? If you don't get all the wires straight into the terminal, disaster. So you'll end up having to twist the wires up again into one before you can get your next shot. But let's avoid this altogether by simply bending the tips down like so. This way, if we miss, we don't have to twist them up just to try again. Now that we're gonna have a better time, let's talk about the terminals we'll be plugging into. Usually, knowing which cable to plug into which terminal is easy enough. Red goes in the red, black goes in the black, right? But what do we do if our cables aren't red and black? Well, perhaps you already knew that you can count the cable with the black line as the black cable, which will go into the negative terminal. But I'm gonna make things even easier for you by letting you in on a little secret. That is, that the color of these cables don't even really matter that much. That's because both sides are made up of the same material. That's right, copper. Even if the wires themselves are different colors. As you can see here, we're gonna use the gold cable for the positive terminals of the speaker and amplifier. And we're gonna switch it up on the other speaker by using the silver cable for the positive terminals. And both are gonna sound equally great. So you see, the colors themselves aren't that big a deal. The reason they do make them in different colors is so that you can tell them apart when you're about to connect them to the corresponding terminals. But why they make them in so many colors other than red and black? You tell me. Maybe they just got tired of those two. Alright, then let's wrap it up with the last tip, which, might I add, is for responsible adults only. If you have your doubts, just skip it, no problem. Okay, go. Let me show you how to get those pesky wires out of the plastic wrap. Most people will just cut it out with a blade or scissors. And if you want to have an even easier time, you could just get some special pliers like these. But if you're not so great with blades, and maybe you don't have special tools, you could use the oldest technology in the book, the flame. Use the lighter to melt away the plastic enclosure. What I do is burn while turning the cable periodically so as to not concentrate heat to a single point, which may end up soldering the internal copper wires. Every now and then, I'll give the plastic a tug until schwing, it's out and the wire is exposed. Remember not to try this if you have your doubts, but what you should do, even if you have your doubts, is subscribe to the channel, so you can learn more ways to get more life out of your electronics. Alrighty then, see you later and goodbye.